world where either you're a villain or you're a superhero. You
Kevin Durant's at that place where the all-time greats get, the crossroads of physical and mental superiority.
Durant goes down holding his leg.
Y'all know who I am. I'm Kevin Durant.
Talk about tilting the Eastern Conference. That's a championship team right away.
Kevin Durant will be here tomorrow at the First Take debate desk. Cannot wait to talk to him about why he left the Warriors, coming back, of course, from injury and playing with Kyrie. Tomorrow, Kevin Durant, right here on First Take.
I don't even think he's scratched the surface yet. I think we're all still getting comfortable with one another. I think he's still getting comfortable out on the floor. But, you know, when he's attacking like that, the guy shoots high in the 80s, 90s from the free throw line. And, you know, that's easy money for him. And it's great for our defense as well. It's great for our team being able to settle a game down like that. So he was wonderful tonight, spectacular in all facets, both offensively and defensively. And we needed it.
LeBron, with high praise for his new teammate, Anthony Davis was a man amongst boys last night, completely taking over. 40 points, 20 rebounds in only 31 minutes. He was also 26 of 27 from the free throw line in LA's 120-91 win over Memphis. Stephen A., looking at you. Do you think this is a recipe for success for this Lakers team?
Nope, not at all. First of all, let me say this. I'm not that overly impressed with Anthony Davis based on what I've seen thus far. I consider him one of the top five players on the planet. If you look at his history, this is over the last 4 years, the last 3 years alone. He has shot in 50%, 53%, and 51% from the field. Last 2 years, 34 and 33% from three-point range. This year, he's only shooting 43% from the field. He's only shooting 27% for three-point range. I don't give a damn what y'all saw last night. You will see better. Anthony Davis can actually look a hell of a lot better. I completely agree with LeBron James in terms of, excuse me, he hasn't even scratched the surface yet. This is not Anthony Davis looks much better than what you have seen. And last night's game against the Memphis Grizzlies, oh, please say it, spare to cry me a river. All right, here's the deal. The Lakers' success has to come through LeBron James. LeBron James has to be who we know he is in order for the Lakers to be successful. Without that, the Los Angeles Lakers ain't nothing but a Hollywood version of the New Orleans Pelicans we've been watching for the last several years. That is it. It's not about what Anthony Davis does. It's about what LeBron James does with Anthony Davis. LeBron James, and I'm not knocking LeBron James by any stretch. I'm just simply pointing out what's needed from him. It can't be spectator, wow, let me sit back and marvel at the greatness of this big fella. This brother can really play. This brother got it going on. Let me feed him the ball. No. It's about LeBron continuing to be what we've known him to be. Anthony Davis elevating his level of play based off of what we've seen thus far this season. And Kyle Kuzma coming back and acclimating. And even then, you still need a piece. I'm sorry, this ain't the recipe. This is the New Orleans Pelicans moving to Hollywood via Anthony Davis. That's what this is. This is not going to be the recipe of success for the Lakers.
If you added LeBron James to the Pelicans, they might have won a championship. What are you talking about? Look, Anthony Davis,
That's what I'm saying, Max.
So if you say it's just the New Orleans Pelicans moving to L.A., if you add LeBron to that, you can win a championship with that.
I'm saying, Max, just watching Anthony Davis feeding him and doing that.
I understand. Look, is LeBron just going to be passive all season? No. But can you run your offense through LeBron feeding AD? Of course you can. Listen, what do I always say about LeBron? Mike and Magic had a baby. It was LeBron James. As he ages, it would behoove LeBron to be more and more Magic Johnson because that style relies less on athletic ability, which diminishes over time. So you can be more of a facilitator and less of a take-it-to-the-rack guy, especially since AD doesn't shoot the ball exceptionally well. You know, when you look at the team, which I like Avery Bradley when it matters because he can shoot and defend when he's right. Danny Green, and when Kuzma gets back, you may have just enough shooting to get where you could play five out sometimes and LeBron can do his thing. But AD is not really a stretch four or five. He can play that role, but that's not where he's best. Yes, you can make AD the focal point. I'll bring it back to Magic again in terms of what LeBron does as probably the best passer in the game. Magic, when he came into the league, Stephen A., was the, you know, rookie of the year and all these things. Kareem won the MVP. And I'm not saying AD is as great as Kareem, but he's certainly an MVP-level player. But the difference here is it ain't a young Magic and an old Kareem. It's an old Magic and a much younger Kareem in terms of the roles they play. Why wouldn't an older Magic feed a much younger Kareem? Even in this NBA, Stephen A., as LeBron pointed out, if AD is hitting his free throws, go ahead, deal with that. He doesn't shoot it great outside the paint, but he shoots it well enough. And maybe LeBron's thought is, I'm going to keep feeding him because he needs touch. You know, he needs to feed, to shoot that outside the paint more to get that overall team offense going. And by the way, all this is to say nothing of half AD's value, which is on the defensive side where he's among the all-time greats. I think the Lakers could absolutely go all the way, even. I would take the Clippers. But you could make AD the most important piece on the team offensively, and the Lakers and LeBron James could ride that. Absolutely. Why not? He's one of the most efficient scorers ever.
I disagree with you, but I can understand why you are wrong on this particular situation. It's no offense to you at all. I can understand exactly what you're thinking. You're thinking about the youth and the greatness of Anthony Davis. Ride that wave. What I'm saying to you, you're ignoring the durability factor. And the fact of the matter is, because durability is been a question mark for Anthony Davis throughout his career, combined with the fact that he doesn't just have an elite offensive arsenal, but he's a guy that could do damage for you on the garbage side of things as well. He can sit up there and score on putbacks. He doesn't just have to get the ball in the post. He can sit up there and hit from the perimeter. He can also be an elite second option, not just an elite first option. The point of the matter is, you have to ask yourself this question: how does it benefit the Lakers for LeBron James to take a step back at the expense, or rather for the reasons of feeding Anthony Davis? I'm saying to you, it's more important for Anthony Davis to adjust and acclimate to playing with the greatness of a LeBron than it is for LeBron to acclimate playing with an Anthony Davis in terms of receiving true success in the National Basketball Association for this upcoming season. I'm not questioning the talent of Anthony Davis by any stretch of the imagination. I'm riding with you on that. But I'm saying you have to take into consideration durability, the kind of game that he's going to bring to the table, and whether or not LeBron James is a person that's truly, truly capable of taking a step back and it not being to the detriment of the team he's stewarding. I'm challenging that's not the case with L.A. He still needs to be that alpha dog in order for them to be successful.
But he still is the alpha dog, even if he's feeding somebody else, because he's running the show. Number one, durability. Let's be honest. Dwight Howard's been a revelation so far. I don't know. Talk about durability. Let's see if he can keep it up. But even when I was critical of the Lakers spending money on JaVale McGee, who, by the way, rightfully clapped back at me on Twitter, I'm not saying JaVale McGee can't play. I just don't think he's your starter. But JaVale McGee can give you minutes at the five. Dwight Howard can clearly still give you minutes at the five. That should take some stress off of Anthony Davis, even though I believe when he's playing the five, that's their best lineup. Again, Avery Bradley, Danny Green, LeBron, Kuzma when he gets healthy, and AD is how you should finish games. But so that's the durability point. The next point about LeBron, should he change his game? Actually, one of the reasons that there's no end in sight for LeBron if he doesn't want there to be is because he can recede where he's goes from clearly the best player in the game to among the best players in the game, still MVP level. He could recede further than that, and still win championships as merely an all-star caliber player because his game is so well-rounded. Because, yes, he could take it to the rack. Yes, he can hit big shots from the outside. But Stephen A., he's maybe the best passer in the NBA, the highest basketball IQ in the NBA.
Like I said, you have your point, I have mine. I'm trying to stick to your point and addressing your points. You're going all around the block. At the end of the day, I'm getting ready to tell you. Dwight Howard, JaVale McGee, it doesn't matter, Max, because you could talk about them insulating Anthony Davis to some degree, but the reality is when he has the ball, and the more he has the ball, the more his durability comes into question. Everybody that goes against him, Montrezl Harrell was a perfect example. Opening night, he knows that from a skill standpoint, he ain't on Anthony Davis Davis's level, as most dudes who are big men in basketball know. They are not on Anthony Davis's level. But everybody recognizes Anthony Davis as a finesse player. So what are we going to do? We're going to get physical with them. We're going to bang him. We're going to make him feel our physicality. And four games into the season, we're talking about a shoulder injury and how long that's going to linger and how that needs to be monitored by Vogel and his staff. These are the kind of things that you have to monitor. So when you give him the ball, particularly in the post, and you're subjecting him to physicality, you're endangering his availability for when it really, really counts.
Load manage,
and you offset
brother.
That by making sure that LeBron James
all right, we gotta go, guys.
Tell you what I'm watching.
What?
I'm seeing 40 and 20 in three quarters.
Yeah, you are. You know it's going to be a lot
Memphis.
Of fun? This
you might
Friday.
Be able to score 20 on Memphis, and you can't play.
When they face the Mavs. You're going to get your guy, Porzingis, Luka, LeBron,
Mavs
AD. That's on ESPN, the games in Dallas this Friday, so that'll be a lot of fun. But so will tonight, live from Boston on SportsCenter, one Stephen A. Smith. That's presented by Mountain Dew, how Giannis's pregame routine helped him become an MVP. Plus, Stephen A. is going to sit down with new Celtics star Kemba Walker, UConn in the building, all leading up to Bucks-Celtics. This is going to be a good one on ESPN Wednesday. At 7 p.m. That is today, also on the ESPN app. Some of the best players in college athletics are very happy today, but should they want more from the NCAA? We'll get into it. Don't go anywhere. It's First Take.